What is up, guys? It is Jax with GnBots.com, and today we are going to be doing our tutorial on using the GnBots software. So for today, we're going to be starting with the Accounts tab. You can get there by going to Overview and then clicking Accounts, and here you're going to see the screen that looks something like this. You're able to do a few different things while you're here, the first one being that you can rename the instance. So what an instance is it is your game account that is connected to the bot. So if you have 10 accounts, you will have 10 different instances. This is how we get around having multiple accounts but running from the same bot. So you could select the name, and you can actually name this anything you want. As you add new accounts, you can name them as well. So maybe you would name it name account one, name account two, etc. Once you've got those names and how you like them, you can choose to enable or disable the accounts or the instances as you like. From here, we've got a few different things. The first one being the health check. If you click this, now you can check your settings all done within the bot just to make sure that it is running correctly. So once you click fix all, it will do its checks and then it will tell you what needs to be fixed, if anything, and then you're able to close it once it's finished. Once you're done with that, you can install the app from here. So if you're playing, let's say, Mafia City, you can get this game easily just by clicking here. No longer do you have to go somewhere and do that externally. And then most importantly, we have the gear icon. So what this thing here is how you edit your settings. You can click that and it's going to bring up the action editor. So this is where you will spend most of your time. This is how you edit anything that you want the bot to do. As you can see over here, you have all of the actions and they are each named, and then you can enable those or disable those as you like. So as you can see, something new for this is that you can change your game that you're playing on. So all of the games and instances are linked independently. So if you want to play four different games, you can easily do that all just by editing from the same action editor. You also have the instance. So instance one would be the one that we are on. Instance two would be the second one, and so on and so forth. And you can add as many instances or accounts as you would like. Here you could select the actions that you want the bot to perform. So in this example, we've got daily activities. Let's go ahead and enable that. And then over here, I can select the individual actions that I want the bot to do within. So as you can see here, I have daily activities and I have gather resources enabled. If I wanted to adjust the order in which those were run in, I can just simply come over here, drag and drop, and those things will be reversed. And you could do that for any action that you have enabled. You can also click this little clock icon right here, and that's going to bring up the rules. Here you could choose to skip, wait after, or close the instance and wait after. So it's just a few different rules that you can choose within each action so that it's only running whenever you want it to. And then you can also, after closing that out, do the final settings, which is here. This is for email, password, slot, and shuffle. So shuffle is going to be adjusting all of the actions that we have enabled. It's going to move those into random orders. And then the email, password, and slot, if you don't know what that is, that's basically for games that allow you to use like an M30 account if you were playing Last Shelter Survival. They are just so that you don't have to actually switch accounts. You can just use the slots that are associated with it. If you don't know what that is, then don't worry about it. It's more of an advanced feature. So finally, once you close all of that out, you're done with the accounts. You can see that they are here. You are ready to move on to the next account, and you do the same thing for that. And if you ever want to delete one, just hit that trash can button and come down and hit confirm, and those will get deleted out of there. After that, we have the logs. All the logs are, it shows what the bot is thinking. So under settings, we have some advanced things that you can do. You can change the language, change your emulator, and then most importantly, number of accounts running at once. So remember that you can have unlimited accounts. It doesn't matter if you have one or you have 1,000, the bot can handle all of those, and each one is going to be its own individual instance. What this is how many run at a single given time. The higher you raise this, the more taxing on your computer or the server it's going to be. So we do not recommend raising this above 4. If you have 20 accounts, you're good with 1. If you have 50 accounts, 2 is probably good. If you have over 100, maybe you're going to use 3. But 4 is going to be pushing it. We don't recommend it, as it's just going to lower your stability. And again, this does not say how many accounts that you have. This is how many run at once. So make sure you pay close attention to that. Fast boot, off or on, you won't need to do that unless we tell you to do that in a support ticket. And don't worry about the remote API. That's the same thing that if we are needing to give you support, we are able to do that. Under updates, you can always check to see if we've done an update. You don't ever need to re-download. The updates will be pushed automatically. And then finally, you've got your license key. You can go ahead and paste it if you've purchased it or choose to get one just by clicking here under Get a License. My account is just going to bring up your account where you can deactivate your subscription or choose to pay. And then support, it's got our guides and other things that we offer. So super simple. If you have any questions, please feel free to write us in the support ticket and we will be happy to assist you. Thank you for watching and happy botting.